Welcome to Learn Somatics. In this video, we're going to do a movement called pelvic circles. And this is like an extrapolation of the arch and flatten movement. So we're taking it to its sort of zenith, if you like. So if you like arch and flatten, you're probably going to really like this movement. Give it a try and let me know how you get on. Okay, so for this movement, obviously we're going to start in arch and flat position, which is laying on our back, knees bent, feet flat. And we're going to begin with some arch and flatten. So if you've been watching the videos, we know that arching and flattening involves arching of the lower back, so our pelvis rolls towards our feet, and then slowly letting it relax and roll back toward our head. So we just want to get a feel for that again, reminding ourselves, oh yeah, this is arch and flatten. I can arch straight down the middle, and then I can flatten straight down the middle. And when I'm flattening, the pressure is in the middle of my lower back that I'm pressing down. Inhaling and arching, and exhaling and flattening. So now we're going to play with this. This time we're going to arch to about half of what our full arch is. So here, I'm going to hold it. You're going to feel like your pressure is in the middle of your tail. And what I want you to do from here is, keeping the arch, you're just going to shift the weight to the left side of your tail, and then back to the right side of your tail. So you can see my hips and legs are moving here. I'm staying in the arch, so I'm just going left of my tail and right of my tail. And you'll notice this feels different. As you shift to the left, the burden of effort shifts from one group of muscles in your back to another. And do this a couple of times, keeping the arch going to the left, going to the right, going to the left, across the middle, and going to the right. And from there, slowly relax. Okay. Now we're going to do the opposite. Now we're going to flatten our back. Flattening our back down. That's making our tail tuck under a bit. We've rolled our tail a little bit towards our feet, or towards our head, should I say. And again, we're going to feel how the pressure is in the middle of the back. And what we're going to do now, we're going to do the same thing we did a moment ago. We're going to shift the weight to the left, and then from across, from the left across the middle into the right. So I'm shifting my weight left to right, but this time doing it with the back flattened as opposed to arched. So okay, I'll just do that a couple of times, nice and easy. Start to feel how you can keep the back flat as you shift the weight to the left, as you shift the weight to the right. And just notice, is it easier to do it with the back flat for you, or was it easier to do it with the back arched for you? Alright. Left and right, right and left. Keeping the back flattened as we do it. And relax. Okay. So we felt how we could go left and right with the back arched and with the back flattened. So let's go further. So go back into an arch, hold, and now shift the weight over to the left of your tail again. Okay, so now my hips have tipped a little bit. Now keeping this left side weight, begin to let your back flatten. So I'm keeping the pressure on the left, and now I'm going to arch again, keeping the pressure on the left. So I'm basically keeping my hips sort of tipped over to one side as I arch and flatten. Arching, keeping the pressure on the left. Flattening, keeping the pressure on the right. Arching, keeping the pressure on the left. Sorry. Flattening, keeping the pressure on the left. So as you can see, we keep the pressure on the left as we arch, and we keep the pressure on the left as we flatten. We're just keeping that left side bias as we go, arching and flattening. So one more time, and then slowly release back to the rest. Okay, so let's do the other side. Go into arch, tip the weight into the right, slide with the tail, and now keep the right side emphasis as we flatten the back. So we're doing arch and flatten, but we're kind of doing it on the right side only. Arching, keeping to the right, flattening, keeping to the right. Arching, keeping to the right, flattening, keeping to the right. time, arching, keeping to the right, and flattening, keeping to the right. And come back to the middle. And then your feet might have moved around a bit from doing that, so just get yourself set again. Now what you may have noticed, when we've just done, from what we've just done, we've kind of drawn four sides of a box. We were going left to right in an arch, we created a line that way. We flattened in an arch, or sorry, we flattened left and right, we created a line this way. And then we did arch and flatten on the left, creating a box this way, and arch and flatten on the right, creating a line this way. So we've outlined a square. So let's see if we can trace that square. So we're gonna arch down the middle, tip the weight to the left, keep left as we flatten. Now, keep flattening as we tip the weight to the right, keep flat. Now, we're gonna arch and stay right. Now we're gonna shift the weight over to the left. We're gonna stay left as we flatten. We're gonna shift to the right as we stay flattened. And we're gonna arch as we go to the right. So we're going around the box. Now we're gonna stay arched as we shift to the left. And now we're gonna flatten as we stay left. We're gonna keep flat as we shift to the right. And we're gonna arch as we stay right. So we're outlining this box as we go around. So can we make it not a box now, but more like a circle? So just keep doing the movement. And we're just rolling the pressure around our tail. So now I'm on the left as I arch. I'm gonna stay left as the back flattens. As it flattens, I'm kind of gonna let it come around to the middle. Then I'm gonna shift the weight around to the right. Then I'm gonna arch. As I arch, I'm gonna let the weight go across the center to the left. And as I flatten, I'm gonna stay left, shift into the middle. So we've gone from making a square to kind of making a circle. So keep making this circle and see how circular you can make it. Arching across the center, flattening, I'm staying left, then I'm coming through middle again, out to the right, then arching out to the right, arching through center, arching out to the left, flattening down the left, flattening through center, out to right, arching out to the right. Okay. Can we change directions? Now I'm arching to the right, flattening through the right, flattening through center, flattening through left, arching through left. So now we're making these nice pelvic circles, basically making a circle with our tail. Hitting all the different sort of angles of an arch and flatten in a nice circular motion. Okay, continue that out for one or two more. And then slowly relax the rest. Let your legs out straight. See how that feels. Notice how your low back feels on the table, how your hips feel, how your legs feel. That's a great movement to free up your lower back. By moving in a circle, we ensure that we address the entire lower back. We get all the angles as we're going through the circles. If you find that hard, you know, you can stick with just doing the singular pieces of it. Arching on one side, arching or sending the weight left to right. And when you get proficient at doing all the different elements of it, then you'll be able to put it together in a circle. Give that a try and see how you get on.